Parts of Mindanao still experiencing floods and landslides amid heavy rains caused by a low-pressure area. At least five people were killed in Davao de Oro, including a 12-year-old girl who died in a landslide in the town of Malagusan.
The number of families affected, pwede umabot po tayo sa mahigit 3,600 families. In terms of infrastructure damage, again, umabot po tayo sa mga 57 reported roads and bridges damage.
In Davao Oriental, many roads were impassable due to landslides. The water level in the Davao River has also reached the critical mark. At least 15 villages, meanwhile, were affected by floods in Davao City, displacing more than 2,000 families. Labang Zamora Transition Authority rejects the proposal of former President Rodrigo Duterte for a separate and independent Mindanao. Duterte said a signature campaign has already begun for this endeavor and that he has tasked Davao del Norte Representative Pantaleon Alvarez to lead the effort. But Labang Zamora Transition Authority asserts secession is not the solution.
Both fronts have already abandoned their call for secession. And in fact, the MILF have downgraded their call for the establishment of an Islamic State to a meaningful and a genuine self-governance. And currently, we can say that both fronts are doing well in the Bangsamoro transition process. And the situation does not allow us, you know, it's not even, there's no basis to go back to the call for secession. Kung may problema naman ho yata sa how the system works, we even need to go back to the Constitution. And there are processes there that that can be availed of to settle all our problems. And in fact, charter change nga ho is a remedy to solve our problems. And it's not necessarily secession.
The charter change saga continues. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. urged to firmly stand against the people's initiative to amend the Constitution. His sister, Senator Aimee Marcos, asserts she will not let their family name be ruined again amid disputes over charter change.
This is no mere family squabble. We're talking about the Republic and the Constitution and the heart and soul of democracy here in our country. Kung sino man ang nagsimula niyan, kamag-anak ko man o hindi, talagang tututulan ko. As I've said many times, we are the most fortunate family on earth, with the grace and blessing of a second chance.
Leaders of the House of Representatives meanwhile hope tensions between the two chambers of Congress will simmer down soon as the Senate prepares to tackle charter change next week.
What the House wants is we'll just avoid na a clash with the Senate. Kasi kumbaga sa kuan, boss, eh, para kaming pamilya rin, magkakapatid eh. Why do we fight with our brothers, di po ba? Instead of just focus on our work, which we still have a lot of work to do. Whatever it is, ang statement niya ni Speaker kahapon pa, we will abide. Pati yung sinasabi earlier na report na dadaling sa Supreme Court, ng Senate, itong PI na ito. Kung ano man na desisyon ng Supreme Court, then sabi niya ni Speaker, we will follow that.
The Philippine Vice President flatly denies accusations by a self-confessed assassin who linked her to alleged extrajudicial killings in Davao City. She challenged her accuser to file charges in court. Joyce Balancho reports.
Vice President Sara Duterte questions the timing of the allegations against her by retired police Arturo Las Cañas. The self-confessed gunman tagged Duterte as the brains behind Oplan Tokhang when she was the mayor of Davao City. Oplan Tokhang was the infamous anti-drug campaign from Davao City, which allegedly involved the extrajudicial killings of drug suspects.
May kinalaman umano ako sa Oplan Tokhang, sa Davao Death Squad, at sa mga insidente ng pagpatay o extrajudicial killings sa Davao. Bago ang script na ito, sa mga taon na nagsilbi ako bilang vice mayor at mayor ng Davao City, niminsan ay hindi naugnay ang aking pangalan sa isyong ito.
The VP believes the allegations are part of attempts to include her in the case pending before the International Criminal Court or the ICC.
Bigla na lang nagkaroon ng testigo laban sa akin nang mahalal ako na Vice President. Maliban sa tiyempo, malinaw na sadyang pinilit lang na maidugtong ang pangalan ko sa isyong ito para ako maging akusado sa ICC.
The Vice President challenges Las Cañas and those supporting him to file a murder case against her in a Philippine court. She reiterates she does not recognize the jurisdiction of the ICC. Las Cañas earlier dared the Duterte family to face him and disprove his allegations. He claims thousands were killed under Oplan Tukhang during VP Duterte's term as mayor.
Ang dami pong namamatay dito, ang daming namimissing. Meron pong mga more or less 3,000. Pero ang total damage o napatay sa Davao City, yung nakita at saka yung missing, more or less 10,000.
Las Cañas also said Senator Bongo is complicit in the extrajudicial killings, claiming he provided the information on people who would be the target of the anti-drug operations.
Para for sure na makuha talaga namin ang target is kumukuha si Bongo ng personal identification data. Ito kompleto po sa detalye kung saan nakatira ang target, anong sasakyan ang gamit niya.
According to Las Cañas, former President Rodrigo Duterte is the leader of drug lords in Davao City.
Lahat po ng mga drug lords sa Davao City ang personal po pong kakilala at ito po ay mga allies po ni Rodrigo Duterte.
He also named Davao City 1st District Congressman Paolo Duterte as the one behind the smuggling of narcotics into the city when he was vice mayor.
Nagwe-withdraw po kami ni Mark Rico ng pera every Friday po ito sa tatlong bangko. Ito po ang role ko. Nag-escort ako ng bribe money per instruction po ni Vice Mayor Paolo Duterte.
Las Cañas says even Davao City Mayor Sebastian Duterte is not clear of drug involvement.
Baste wala yan. Addict. Naging mayor pa. So tumayo kayo. Huwag kayong matakot. Labanan natin ang mga ito.
Las Cañas said he has given all these testimonies and other pieces of evidence to the team of the International Criminal Court, which conducted a pretrial investigation last February 2022. Former Davao City Police Chief and now Senator Ronald Bato de la Rosa shrugged off allegations against him.
Sige, gawin siya, pabaya mo lang yan. Sige, mag-alig siya na mag-alig. Basta malinis siya, konsensya ko. Sabi mo, bahala siya sa buhay.
Senator Bongo meanwhile called Las Cañas' statements pure lies and fabrication. ABS-CBN News has reached out to Congressman Paolo Duterte and Davao City Mayor Sebastian Duterte for their comments, but they have not released any statements on the issue. Alliance of Concerned Teachers Representative Franz Castro, meanwhile, plans to file a resolution to urge the House of Representatives to investigate the allegations against the Duterte family. Joyce Balancho, ABS-CBN News.
The names and data of lotto winners in the Philippines have been submitted to a Senate panel investigating alleged rigging of the state-run lottery. The Philippine Charity Sweepstakes Office, or PCSO, turned over the information to the Senate Committee on Games and Amusement. The committee's chairman, Senator Rafi Tulfo, says they will verify whether the winners were actual bettors. The chief of staff of the PCSO general manager told the committee that the lottery system cannot be edited. But her statement contradicted an earlier admission by PCSO's IT manager that anyone with access to the system can manipulate it.
Mr. Chair, when you have access, it does not mean that you can edit. It's not editable, Mr. Chair. So our apologies for the statement last time, but it is not as if when you have access, it is not a document that you can edit.
Why are you saying that na hindi pwede? Eh samantalang yung nandito ka last time na hearing namin, IT expert yung sabi niya pwede. So ngayon binabago mo. Hindi pwede. Maliban na kung magpakita sa akin ng credentials na ikaw ay IT expert.
No, Mr. Chair.
Then hindi ka pwede magsalita.
Craving for a gastronomic feast this Chinese New Year? Here's the rundown of some treats in Manila's Chinatown that won't break the bank. Take a look.
The Chinese New Year is approaching, and Manila Chinatown is bustling with activity. Not only for those interested in buying lucky charms, but also for food enthusiasts. Carvajal Street offers meticulously crafted fresh lumpia, a healthy choice with an authentic recipe passed down through generations.
It's authentic from China. Yung specialty pa ni Lola ko. Tapos to Papa, tapos ako. Tapos fresh lagi yung mga veggie natin everyday.
If you're looking for affordable, authentic Chinese cuisine, this Xiaolongbao is the perfect choice at only 200 pesos. It's made to order and arrives at your table piping hot. Patrons say it's a must try.
Legit, traditional talaga. So very good, 10 out of 10.
Indulging in authentic Chinese cuisine doesn't have to break the bank. Here in Ongpin Corner Salazar Street, foodies can take their time and have a pick of different barbecue offerings from tofu to various meat sticks.
Sulit naman po kasi matitikman mo yung ibang lasa ng pagkain, like Chinese food nga po siya, ganun. Wala siya sa Pinoy, di ba? Kaya sulit na rin po sa 120, tsaka experience po siya.
For those in the know, this bakery on Titana Street offers a mouth-watering prosperity cake at just 78 pesos. The owner says it's filling and even brings good luck.
Gawa po siya sa sweet potato or kamote, sir. So rich in fiber po siya. Yan po yung maganda dyan. Kaya mga taong nagda-diet, pwedeng isang piraso lang pong kainin niya, ay busog na po yan sigurado, sir. Tumpak na yan.
A favorite among locals is chicken feet offered at a mobile store along One Luna Street. Vendors say it's a crowd favorite.
Sakto lang ang timpla, kaya laging maraming kumakain dito sa may Binondo. Pabalik-balik ang mga tao dahil sa sobrang sarap.
Many have made the trip to Manila Chinatown for the food, and they say it's an experience that enriches the spirit and satisfies taste buds.
It's really underrated. It's something that a lot of people don't know about, and I'm glad that I'm here today.
If you're really a foodie, go to Binondo.
And that's advice you can really sink your teeth into. Jeffrey Hernandez, ABS-CBN News.